if we see TCS, a continuous selling took place, and this was the range for TCS to find its support. So TCS did find its support around this 2320 mark. It basically came back, Moriwazu was formed, it comes back, does not go below the Moriwazu level, and it opens gap up, right? So it opens gap up, again comes down, but yet these levels are sustained by TCS, and then it goes higher. So ideally, I am looking to buy TCS if it comes under this zone where the rally, previous rally had started from. So I would be buyer in TCS only around this 2375 mark. Right now, I cannot be just a buyer in TCS. We do not see any kind of reversals in either the uptrend which is happening. More or less, I would suggest there is a downturn which is happening in TCS. Right. So even if we draw all the highs which have been formed, it is basically a descending triangle formation which is taking place in TCS. So I'm not buyer in TCS as such, but yes, if it comes along these 2375 or 2325 levels, I would be keen buyer in TCS for the reversal trades. Now, nothing has happened. So earnings have not come along TCS. So agreed that it won't go high, but a bigger downside is not there for TCS. So people who do not want to trade INFI, they can basically watch out to trade TCS on the IT pack. Right, and the important levels for TCS would be around these two points, 2325 and 2375. Right, so we would like to watch out if we can find reversal for TCS along these lines.